Hey folks, how we doing? I just got some chill tunes going on here. I'm gonna try to keep this real fun at the beginning of each lecture, all right? All right, welcome to my living room, your classroom for the next 16 weeks. I'm gonna keep it fun. We're gonna have a little bit of music here at the beginning. While I'm kind of warming up and getting into it, I think that's pretty good. All right, let's get into this thing. Okay. What up, followers? All right, so what I have in front of me here are your lecture slides, and I'm gonna be annotating and taking notes on top of these. And then of course I'll export that and you can download that and see my notes. I'm also going to share with you my notes from last year. And if you see my hand here with this funky looking half Michael Jackson glove, this is for my tablet writer, okay, so that my hand doesn't draw, or so that my hand doesn't drag across the thing. So this is normal. Okay, so let's get into it. So chapter one, day one, week one. Here we go. So this is kind of a breakdown of, believe it or not, everything in the universe. So we start with all matter. Can it be separated by a physical process? So it's, we can just ask the first simple question. So this is like everything, you, me, this computer, a tree, the earth, the universe, everything, all matter. Can it be separated by a physical process? If no, okay, this tells us it's a pure substance, okay? And that doesn't mean that we stop there. It's not the only thing that a pure substance could be. So we could then ask another question. Can it be decomposed by a chemical process? Okay, so we're gonna have to get into understanding these differences between physical processes and chemical processes. Okay, but if we answer this question, yes, if it's a pure substance, and we can be separated by a chemical process, then it is a compound, okay? Another thing that we could call that would be a molecule. Let's make this a little bit thinner. So a molecule would be another name for a compound. And so here is this nice picture of ice, and we know ice is H2O. It's the solid form of two hydrogens bonded to one oxygen. And so that chemical process could separate the hydrogen and the oxygen. So that is what makes it a compound or a molecule. And if we can't separate it by a chemical process, then it is an element, okay? So for example, pure gold here, chemical symbol AU. Okay, so what if we go back to now this top question? We have all matter. Can it be separated by a physical process? If yes, then it's a mixture, okay? Which means it's more than one pure substance. And then we could go further and we could say, is it uniform? And if not, we call that heterogeneous, okay? And if yes, if it is uniform, we call that homogeneous, okay? For the Latin hetero or homo, so meaning that it's either uniform or it's not uniform, okay? And so now we have two kind of interesting for fun examples here, vinegar and salad dressing. And you might be thinking to yourself, if you know how to make salad dressing, then yes, vinegar is in salad dressing. But there is also other stuff in salad dressing, like olive oil, water, salt, maybe some lemon, maybe some garlic, maybe some pepper, you know, make your salad dressings tasty, okay? And we know that it is heterogeneous because look at these different layers, right? If you've made salad dressing before, you know that the oil and the water and the vinegar will all separate and you can mix it and get it to go uniform. But if you let it sit for a long enough time, it will separate. So that's what we call heterogeneous. Vinegar, as it turns out, is composed of acetic acid. We'll get to know acetic acid quite a bit. And H2O. So there's the pure acetic acid as well as water. So that's the mixture, but it's homogeneous because you would never know that there's both the acetic acid and the water in that vinegar. Okay? Okay, I'm gonna move on to the next slide. Hopefully we're feeling pretty good about this. Okay, so now let's kind of get into this element compound thing a little bit more. Okay, and so here's some fun pictures that we have. So an element, a better definition, a pure substance, so we know it's a pure substance, okay, that cannot be broken down into simpler substances. Okay, and so you can see this picture, like a single atom, such as something like helium, or even argon, or even neon. So these are just some examples of what we call the noble gases, okay? And so they're just singular atoms, so they can't be broken down, okay? So now, what about a compound? So we said another word for a compound could be a molecule, okay? All right, that's a little E at the end there. You have to bear with me. As you can tell, my handwriting isn't the best, and this digital pen thing is new for me, so patience, and with practice, we'll make perfect. Okay, so a compound is still a pure substance, but now it's composed of two or more elements that can only be separated by a chemical reaction. So here, this what I have is a picture of carbon dioxide, CO2, and we could certainly do some chemistry and break this down into carbon and oxygen, okay? So now, what about this picture right here? These two little mystery blue balls here, compound or element? I want you to think about this. Pause the video if you have to. Think about this. Is that a picture of a compound or an element? Okay. This one's tricky. As it turns out, that's an element. And the reason is because it's only made up of one element. So you can think of each of those two different balls are the same element. So we know a compound is two or more elements. Well, here there's only one thing, okay? And so these are examples of what we call diatoms, and the naturally occurring elemental diatoms are the following: hydrogen gas, H2, or it could be a liquid or a solid too, depending on the temperature, but we'll just say hydrogen. Oxygen, we know oxygen's O2. Nitrogen is N2. And we have then all of the halogens, which is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. And so these are the examples of diatoms that I want you to know. So these are elements, they exist in nature as these diatoms, okay? And we could certainly break these down into single atoms, like two single oxygen atoms, but they don't survive very long. They want to come back and bond. And so the main thing here is that all of these are not two or more. It's just the same atom in these elements, okay? In these diatoms.